good morning all of you. Today we'll learn about EMF equation of the transformer. So electromotive force equation or EMF equation of the transformer. So transformer operates on the principle of Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. So that means transformer operates on AC supply only, alternating current supply. So when we give alternating supply in a transformer, primary winding, we transform primary winding, alternating current will flow. Alternating current will flow. So that alternating current produces flux. The flux produced by the primary winding links the primary winding. An EMF will be induced in the primary, that is called self-induced EMF. That is E1 value. So self-induced EMF, E1 value. So this is the primary coil of the transformer, secondary coil of the transformer. When we give alternating supply to the primary, so an alternating current will flow. So this is the alternating current. First of all, we apply voltage. From that voltage, so that is the alternating voltage. From that voltage, current will flow. That is the alternating current. That current produces flux. The flux is the alternating flux. So the flux produced by the primary coil. So this is the primary coil. Flux is induced from the primary coil. Alternating flux. Flux is also alternating. An EMF will be induced on primary. An EMF will be induced on primary. That is called self-induced EMF, E1. So induced EMF in the primary, E1. The flux produced by the primary links with the secondary coil. EMF induced in the secondary, that is called mutually induced EMF, E2. Mutually induced EMF, E2. So this is the E2 value. So this EMF is called mutually induced EMF. So this induced EMF is because of flux produced by the primary links with the secondary. So this is the flux produced by the primary links with the secondary, E2. So this is the E1 value. So we derive the equation for these EMFs, E1 and E2. So these are the EMF equations of the alternators. We derive equation for E1 and we derive the equation for E2. So these are the EMF equations of the transformer, electromotive force equations of the transformer. Okay. So first we apply alternating voltage to the primary. So this alternating voltage, this AC voltage, produces alternating current. So in a closed loop, if we apply voltage in a closed loop, current will flow. So that current produces flux. So this is also alternating flux. So the alternating flux produced by the primary links with the primary winding EMF will be induced. So this is called self-induced EMF. So same flux links with the secondary coil, EMF induced on the secondary. So this is called mutually induced EMF. Mutually induced EMF, self-induced EMF. So we derive the equations for these two, E1 and E2. So that is the EMF equation of the transformer. So in a transformer, source of alternating current is applied, that means voltage, current and flux to the primary winding. So the current in the primary winding is called magnetizing current. Magnetizing current. So this is the magnetizing current I. Magnetizing current will flow in the primary. Produces flux in the core of the transformer. That is the flux produces. So this alternating flux gets linked with the secondary winding because of the phenomenon of mutual induction. An EMF will be induced. This is a very, very important point. Mutual induction. So transformer operates on Faraday's laws. That is nothing but mutual induction. And gets EMF induced in the secondary winding. The magnitude of this induced EMF can be found by using the following EMF equation of the transformer. Okay. Now, so this is all about the equation parameters. N1, number of terms in the primary winding. N2, same number of terms in the secondary. So this is the primary winding, secondary winding. So transformer core is represented in this manner, two parallel lines. We apply primary alternating voltage to the alternating voltage. V1. So this will circulate the current. So that is called I1. So from this I1 we produce flux. So that flux will induce the primary EMF will be induced on the primary. It is called self induced EMF E1. So this primary having number of turns N1. So same flux links with the secondary common flux. So this is the flux produced by the primary links with the primary as well as the secondary. EMF will be induced on secondary E2. Secondary turns N2. So this is the voltage, thermal voltage of the transformer that is reflected with the V2. When load is connected, secondary current will flow, I2. V1, I1, N1, N2, E2, V2. When load is connected, I2. When not connected, I2 equal to 0. When load is connected, I2 will exist. So N1 primary turns, N2 secondary turns, phi is the maximum flux in the core. Flux, maximum flux in the core. So there is the flux density, area of the core. Because the flux density Bm equal to flux by area. Flux density equal to flux by area, maximum value of flux by area. So from this flux equal to Bm into A. Flux density equal to flux by area. Flux equal to Bm into A. If you see the frequency of the alternating supply, if you see the frequency of this alternating supply, as shown in the figure, the flux rises. As shown in the figure means this figure. So when we give alternating voltage, so this is the alternating voltage. So this is the alternating voltage. From this alternating voltage, we produce current, alternating current, same alternating current. From this alternating current, we get the alternating flux, this value of flux. First voltage, current, and then the flux. So this is the alternating flux. Alternating, this alternating flux is because of alternating current. So this alternating flux means having positive cycle and negative cycles. So this is the positive cycle of the alternating source. Alternating flux. So this is the negative cycle of the alternating flux. So this cycle is one complete cycle. So frequency means cycles per second. So this is the time period to complete the one cycle is capital T. So capital T is the time period to complete the one cycle. So this is the time period of the cycle. So to complete one fourth is the half for positive cycle half. So this is the 1/4 cycle. So 1/4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So they keep a 4 time. So in this time, flux completes 1/4 cycle. So this is the maximum value of flux. This is the maximum value of flux. So that means when we give voltage, alternating voltage, V equal to V maximum into sin omega t. So this is the alternating source. And sinusoidal varies. This produces current. So that current equal to also same, I equal to I maximum. I maximum into sine omega t. So this is alternating current. So this alternating current produces flux. The flux is equal to phi maximum into sine omega t. Phi maximum into sine omega t. Okay. V equal to V maximum sine omega t. I equal to I maximum sine omega t. Phi equal to phi maximum sine omega t. But depending upon the reactance of the winding, here exists some lagging or leading. So sin omega t plus phi, some difference, some phase angle difference. So theta, some theta is existing depending upon the winding type. Omega t plus theta. So omega t minus theta. Same here also, omega t plus theta. Okay. So depending upon that value. So but this is alternating flux. This is not necessary here. The phase difference is not required. Only take when the phase difference. So this is the 1/4 cycle. Here the flux is zero. From here, to raise the flux, time required is T by 4. Here the flux value is the maximum value, phi maximum. Here flux is zero. So as we shown in the figure, the flux rises. Flux rises sinusoidally to its maximum value. This maximum from zero value. It reaches to maximum value in 1/4 of the cycle, per Plancton cycle, that is T by 4 seconds, where T is the time period of the sine wave. So frequency means number of cycles per second. So number of cycles per second means here the frequency equal to T equal to 1 by F, T equal to 1 by F. So frequency is inversely proportional to time period, 1 by F. So T equal to 1 by F. So the average rate of flux change equal to pi maximum by T by 4. So that I will explain. According to Faraday's laws, the average value of EMF induced is equal to rate of change of flux in this, rate of change of flux in this. So this is the EMF induced minus d phi by dt minus the indicates induced EMF always opposite cause of its position according to Lenz's laws. So according to Faraday's laws, the average value of EMF induced or the instantaneous value of EMF induced V equal to minus d phi by dt, where n equal to 1, or if you remove the proportionality, if you replace proportionality, the instantaneous value of EMF induced V equal to d phi by dt. If you remove the proportionality, some constant will exist. So minus sign for the negative according to Lenz's law. So this is equal to d phi by dt. So the instantaneous value of EMF induced or average value of EMF induced minus n into d phi by dt. So d phi means change in flux, d phi means change in flux, dt means change in time. So change in flux is from maximum zero value to maximum value. Change in time is 1/4 of the time, t by 4 time, t by 4, t by 4 minus 0. So this is equal to this equation. The average rate of change of flux equal to d phi by dt. M is not being there. No? D phi by dt. Phi maximum value of flux by t by 4. So t equal to 1 by f. So this is the average rate of change of flux. It is 4 phi f. 4 phi f is the frequency. Phi maximum, phi m is the maximum value of flux. So now the induced EMF for one term, per term, equal to rate of change of flux per term. So this is average EMF per term equal to same value, 4 phi f. Suppose if there exist n terms, multiply the equation with n. Now, so this is the average value of EMF induced. This is the average value of EMF induced per term. So the average value of EMF induced is 4 phi f, maximum value of flux. But in case of sinusoidal waveform, so RMS value equal to average value. RMS value equal to average value by form factor. Or form factor equal to, in case of sinusoidal waveform. Case of sinusoidal waveform, or form factor equal to RMS value, form factor. Case of sinusoidal waveform, form factor equal to RMS value by average value. So for sinusoidal waveform, form factor equal to 1.1. Sinusoidal waveform, form factor equal to 1.11 value. This is you will learn the form factor in networks or circuits. So the form factor equal to 1.11 for sinusoidal waveform. So form factor equal to average value, RMS value by average value. So that is equal to 1.11. So therefore, average value, RMS value equal to form factor into 1.1. So So the RMS value of the EMF induced RMS value equal to form factor on the average value 4.5 into F. This is equal to 4.44 frequency into maximum value of flux. So here the average value is 4F5M. The RMS value is 4.44 into 5M because form factor is 1.11 for sinusoidal waveform. So this is the EMF induced for one turn, per turn is by N. So the total EMF induced in the transformer primary winding having N1 turns. So therefore the total induced EMF in the transformer primary winding E1 equal to 4.44 frequency N1 5M. So here the frequency and 5 maximum value is common for both primary and secondary. Only number of turns varies, N1 varies, E1 varies. Similarly, N2 means E2. Similarly, N2 means E2. So here also, 4.44 is common, frequency is common, flux is common. Only N2 means E2, N1 means E1. This is the RMS value of EMF induced. Root mean square value, RMS means root mean square value. So form factor equal to RMS value by average value for sine value waveform. That form factor is 1.11. So that derivation is there in your circuits, subjects. So that value is 4.4. Therefore, E1 by N1 equal to E2 by N2. E1 by N1, EMF per one turn in primary, EMF per turn in secondary. E1 by N1, EMF per turn in primary, E2 by N2 in secondary. 4.44 frequency, flux, maximum value of flux. So this value is constant. This value is a constant for a particular transformer. We know that frequency equal to 50 Hz. Frequency is 50 Hz in our country, so 50. So 5 maximum value is known. That means EMF of turn in the transformer is same for both cases, in primary and secondary. If you know the flux, you need to calculate the EMF pattern in the primary, EMF pattern in the second. So this is the EMF equation of the transformer. Generally, the EMF equation is given by E equal to, in a transformer, equal to 4.44 frequency, maximum value of flux, number of turns, not referred to N1 or N2. If you replace N1, here E1. If you place N2, N2, E2. So these are the EMF equations of the transformer. So general equation is equal to RMS value. This is the RMS value. 4.44 frequency, maximum value of flux, number of turns. So this is all about the EMF equation of the transformer. Okay. Once again, I repeat the same equation. So EMF of the transformer. So when we apply an alternating voltage to the primary winding, because the transformer is made with two copper windings. For a single phase transformer, it has two coils, primary coil and secondary coil, the primary winding and secondary winding. So when we apply alternating voltage to the primary coil, an alternating flux will set up. So that alternating flux set up by the primary links with the same coil, an EMF will be induced in the primary, that is called self-induced EMF E1. So the same flux set up by the primary links in the secondary, an EMF will be induced in the secondary. That inducement is called mutually induced EMF E2. So E1, E2. E1 is the self-induced EMF, E2 is the mutually induced EMF. So transformer operates in mutual induction principle because of secondary induced EMF. The magnitude of this induced EMF can be found by using EMF equation of the transformer. So that is the E1 value. According to Faraday's laws, the rate of flux linkages is proportional to E. E is proportional to d phi by d. We know that Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. Faraday first law states that when flux linking with the conductor changes, EMF will be induced. That is Faraday's first law. Flux linking with the conductor changes, EMF will be induced in the conductor. According to Faraday's second law, the average value of EMF induced in the conductor or coil is proportional to d get the average value of m of induced. Average value of m of induced above d phi by dt. So if you remove the proportionality, some constant is there, that is the n value. Minus sign depends on the negative induced limit always opposes cause of its production. The n minus n into d phi by dt. Now, the average value of EMF induced per one term is given by minus d phi by dt. Minus d phi by dt. Ilagana change derivation mana ilagana simple ga chesukochu. Ila chestunnamo 5 plus lo 5 maximum into sin omega t plus chestunnam. D phi by dt lo 5 plus lo 5 maximum into sin omega t. So if we differentiate the 5 maximum into sin omega t, we get 5 maximum into cos omega t into omega. Also we get into omega. So from that also we get the same equation. So this is another manner of equation. See, EMF average value of EMF induced per one term. So the average value rate of change of EMF per one term. One per term means n is equal to 1. Per term means n equal to 1. So differentiate or difference between the fluxes for 1/4 cycle from 0 to pi maximum. That means 5m. From time is time required is t by 4. So 5 maximum value by t equal to 1 by f, t equal to 1 by f. So 5 maximum by 1 by 4f. So if the average rate of flux equal to 4 to 5, 5 maximum value. Here the flux is 0 here. Flux is maximum here. Difference is 5 maximum minus 0. 5 maximum minus 0. 5 maximum value. Next type. Time required is t by 4. Time required is t by 4. This is the average value of EMF induced for one term. Average value of EMF induced for one term. So equal to 5 maximum by t by 4. Where t equal to 1 by f. So 1 by 4f. 1 by 4f means 4f 5m. Very simple. So this is equal to average value of EMF induced for one term. The average value of EMF induced per one term. So if so for sinusoidal waveform, form factor equal to RMS value by average value. So RMS value equal to form factor into average value. For sinusoidal waveform, form factor equal to 1.11. So therefore RMS value equal to 1.11 into average value. So RMS value equal to, see, RMS value equal to this value, RMS value equal to 1.11 into average value of EMF is 4.445 EMF. So this is the RMS value of EMF for one term, per term. So for total number of terms N1, total number of terms N1, this is the RMS value of EMF in the primary. Similarly, for secondary, average value of EMF is RMS value equal to N2 into into that value. So E2 equal to 4.4 flux M2 5. Here E1, N1, E2, N. Our remaining all parameters are same. Frequency and maximum value of flux is same. This is the EMF equation of the transformer. So if you remember, the EMF equation of the DC generator is given by generated EMF in a generator, DC generator, or back EMF in a DC motor. Is given by EG or EB equal to phi Z N by 60 into P by A. So once generator is designed, means P is fixed constant, A is constant, 60 is also constant, so Z is also constant. In generator case, generated EMF EG equal to proportional to flux and number of speed, flux and speed. So in case of flux and speed, here not n is not number of times, n is the speed of the generator, n is the speed of the generator. Here also, in case of transformer, the EMF induced is proportional to E is proportional to 4.44 constant frequency and flux changes, flux, the maximum value of flux n is the number of turns. Number of turns is also called. Here n is the number of turns. Here n is the speed, frequency and the flux. So frequency depends upon speed. This is nothing. Here the speed is existing in generator. Here frequency is existing in the transformer. That is the difference. Flux is not same. Here phi. Here the average value of phi. Here the maximum value of phi. The flux is maximum value. Here the flux is average value. Here frequency is existing. Here is speed is existing. The moment is given by speed. Here the moment is given by frequency. So that is the difference between the generators and the transformers. Here the equation is. So therefore, EMF per turn in primary is same as EMF per turn in second. In a transformer, that is the condition. EMF per turn in primary is same as EMF per turn in second. That is equal to 4.44 into frequency maximum of fix. This is called the EMF equation of the transformer. Okay. So ideal transformer. So what is an ideal transformer? So ideal transformer means. Transformer having two coils. So this is the primary coil and the secondary coil. Any coil in AC circuit is having resistance R1 and the reactance X1. So suppose this is the primary winding R1 X1. Secondary coil having resistance R2, reactance X2. So in AC circuits, reactance is existing. In DC circuits, only resistance is existing. In AC, resistance plus reactance is existing. So for an ideal transformer, resistance equal to zero. For an ideal transformer, resistance equal to zero. Reactance is also equal to zero. So for an ideal transformer, so we apply some voltage, so that value equal to E1. So V1 equal to E1. Similarly, E2 equal to V2. Because impedance drops are 0. Z1 equal to 0. So Z1 means resistance plus reactance. Z1 means primary resistance plus primary reactance. So resistance 0, reactance 0. So therefore impedance of the primary circuit is 0. Impedance 0 means V1 equal to E1. So E2 equal to E2. So let no load V1 equal to V1, E2 equal to V2. V1 is the supply voltage primary winding. V2 is the terminal voltage secondary winding. So what are the factors affecting the induced EMF? So induced EMF depends upon flux, frequency, number of turns. E equal to 4.44, frequency, maximum value of flux, number of turns. Therefore, factors affecting induced EMF. So flux, frequency, number of turns. What are the factors affecting means flux? Frequency, because EMF equation E equal to 4.44. Sorry. Frequency. Maximum value of flux and turns per phase, turns. So this value, induced EMF value, which is the induced EMF value, affecting the maximum value of flux, frequency, number of turns. So flux, frequency, number of turns. So అనే దానిలో ఏమి ఇంప్లికేషన్ ఆఫ్ ద ట్రాన్స్ఫార్మర్ వోల్టేజ్ అండ్ కరెంట్ రేషియోస్ ఆఫ్ ద ట్రాన్స్ఫార్మర్ సో ప్రైమరీ కరెంట్ ప్రైమరీ వోల్టేజ్ సెకండరీ కరెంట్ సెకండరీ వోల్టేజ్ ఇది ద ప్రైమరీ కరెంట్ అండ్ వోల్టేజ్ సెకండరీ కరెంట్ అండ్ వోల్టేజ్ ప్రైమరీ టర్న్స్ సెకండరీ టర్న్స్ సో దిస్ ఇస్ ద ట్రాన్స్ఫార్మర్ కోర్ primary circuit secondary circuit n1 primary winding turns n2 secondary winding turns e1 armature series will be in the primary e2 armature series will be in the secondary so e1 and e2 so e1 by e2 equal to n1 by n2 is equal to 4.24 frequency 5 max square. So voltage ratio of the transformer without load. Voltage ratio means V1 by V2 or V2 by V1. So load terminal voltage V2 is the secondary reverse voltage V2 both are equal at no load condition. At no load condition current equal to 0. So current 0 means voltage is same because reverse drop equal to 0. I2 should be equal to 0. As the primary current at no load is very small, that is V1 equal to E1. Therefore V1 by V2 equal to N1 by N2. Voltage ratios. So voltage, the ratio of primary and secondary terminal voltage V1 by V2 is called voltage ratio. Voltage ratio is different from transformation ratio. So this is the voltage ratio. Voltage ratio means V1 by V2. So transformation ratio means V2 by V1, N2 by E1. So this is the transformation ratio. So that is different with the case, small k. So small k equal to V2 by V1. So that is equal to V2 by E1, that is equal to N2 by N1. So this is called transformation ratio of the transformer. It is defined as ratio of the secondary voltage to primary voltage, the transformer. Transformer voltage ratio means V1 to V2. Transformation ratio means V2 by V1. Turns ratio. Turns ratio is N1 by N2. So this is the turns ratio N1 by N2. Transformer is different ratio of primary turns to secondary turns. N1 by N2. Hypertransform based on the value of K. K is the transformation ratio. When K value is more than 1, the transformer is called a step-up transformer. When K value is less than 1, the transformer is called a step-down transformer. Step-down transformer and step-up transformer. So current ratios are inverse to the voltages. Current ratios are inverse to the voltages. Step up transformer and step down transformer. K greater than 1 step up, K less than 1 step down transformer. When K value equal to 1, the transformer is called isolation transformer. So both primary and secondary winding to the transformer having equal number of turns and K value equal to 1. And K value equal to 1. That is V1 equal to V2, voltage are same, currents are also same. This one, this 1-to-1 transformer is called isolation transformer. It is also called isolation transformer. So generally, these isolation transforms are used in electronic circuits, having same primary and secondary terms to filter the DC components from the AC circuit. So current ratios. A transformer transfer electric power from one side to other side, primary to secondary, with a very high efficiency, that is around 98% to 99% efficiency. If we assume the power loss taken place in the transformer is very low, the efficiency is around 100%. So generally, transformer having 98% to 99% efficiency. 98% to 99% efficiency. If you neglect the 1% loss, then transformer have almost 100% efficiency. So therefore, efficiency is 100% means input power equal to output power. If you neglect the small amount of losses, that is because transformer have 99% efficiency at full load. If you neglect the 1%, because the transformer have 100% efficiency, therefore input power equal to output power. So input AC power equal to V1 I1 cos theta equal to output AC power V2 I2 cos theta. V1 input voltage, I1 input current, cos theta 1 input power factor. So therefore input power equal to V1 I1 cos theta equal to output power V2 I2 cos theta because losses are neglected. So cos theta 1 and cos theta 2 are the power factors of the primary and secondary one. Practically they have same values. Almost approximately equal. Cos theta 1 equal to cos theta 2. So therefore V1 equal to I1, therefore V1. So input powers are same. V1 I1 equal to V2 I2. So therefore I1 by I2 equal to V2 by V1, that is equal to I2 by yeah. So therefore from this equation, we can understand that. So currents and voltages are inverse ratio in transformers. Currents and voltages are inverse ratios in transformers. Here V2 by V1, here I1 by I2. So current sum will be what? Because if you increase the voltage values, current values will increase. If you step up the voltage, current values will step down. So in that manner, we reduce the power loss in transmission lines. So rating of the transformer, generally, the rating of the machine should be indicated in power supply by it. Suppose we have lamps, motors, the power rating in watts or kilowatts or horsepower. Watts or kilowatts or horsepower from a power rating of the motors. But a transformer rating is in K volt amperes. A transformer rating is in volt amperes because volt amperes, transformer rating is voltage into current, that is volt amperes, kilovolt amperes, megavolt amperes, megavolt amperes, volt amperes, kilovolt amperes or megavolt amperes. That will explain here, I will explain the rating of the transformer. Then the rating is the volt amperes or kilovolt amperes or megavolt amperes. Indicates the power supplied by it, but in case of transformer, the power is not constant because output power depends upon load. So under no load condition, I2 equal to 0. I2 0 means output power equal to 0, but we give some amount of input power to the transformer to meet the losses in the transformer. Keep changing with the load, the output factor is also constant the load. And the rating of the transformer is in terms of voltage and currents. The rating of the transformer is equal to primary voltage into primary current or secondary voltage into secondary current. That is V1, I1 or V2, I2. Same, both are same. Because voltage increases, current value decreases, but the power remains constant. Power remains constant. So therefore, the rating of the transformer is given in terms of rated value of voltage and rated value of current. In the primary or secondary, both are rated values, not no load values are like that. V1 and I1 are the rated value of voltage, rated value of current in primary. V2, I2, rated value of voltage, rated value of current. secondary. So rating is expressed in rated values. If the voltage and current may or may not be in phase, the units of the transformer are volt amperes, that is VA, kilovolt amperes, that is kVA, or megavolt amperes, that is MVA. Rating in VA or kVA or MVA is called voltage into current in the primary or voltage into current in the secondary. V1, I1 or V2, I2. Only the transformer rating is in volt amperes or kilovolt amperes. So there are two types of losses in the transformer, that is copper losses and core losses. Core losses means hysteresis losses and repeated losses. So in any machine, copper losses take in certain current which is passing through the transformer, while the iron losses or core losses is insulator loss depends upon the voltage. So copper losses depends upon current, core loss depends upon voltage. One depends upon current, second one depends upon voltage. Total losses depends upon voltage into current. Total losses depends upon voltage into current and not on power factor. Therefore, rating of the transformer is in voltage into circuit voltage in power factor. Okay. So the complete rating of the transformer is given in this manner. Complete rating of the transformer. So these are the voltage ratings, V1 by V2 or V2 by V1. Power rating, 5 kVA. Frequency rating 50 Hz. So 250 volts is the secondary voltage. So 3300 is the primary voltage. 5 kVA is the rating of the machine power, apparent power, and 50 Hz is the supply frequency. In this manner, transformer rating is given. So these are the specifications of the transformer. So in the nameplate of the transformer, we give these specifications. So that is a kVA rating, primary voltage, primary current, frequency of the operation, type of cooling used, number of phases, secondary voltage, secondary, and number of phases, single phase, or two phase, three phase, like that. So number of phases, secondary voltage, secondary current, primary voltage, secondary voltage, primary current, and secondary current. So in this manner, these are the specifications given in the nameplate of the transformer. Tomorrow we will discuss about the losses in the transformer. There is a copper losses and the core loss of the transformer, losses and efficiency of the transformer.